Now that we've covered all the options and variants that you'll have to consider when building your AR, now we can talk about the tools that you'll need to have, should have, and would like to have. If you're just going to pin on an already built upper and lower receiver together, then you won't need anything special in tools. If you're going to do any other barrel work or stock work, then you'll need to have a stock and barrel tool or a combination tool that will work for both. The barrel nut and receiver extension nut are unique and require special tools, so running down to the hardware store just won't work. These tools are designed to fit other types of fasteners that you use on your rifle, so they also eliminate clutter on the bench and are handy to take out in the field. They also have a half-inch cut in them to accept breaker bars and torque wrenches, so you can accurately torque your barrel and receiver extension nuts. To firmly hold the upper and lower receivers while working on them, you'll have an upper and lower receiver vise blocks. These firmly hold your firearm in a vise without damaging the finish or distorting the receivers. If you're going to work on the mil-spec gas block, then you'll need to have 5 different types of punches to drive in or out 3 different types of pins. The gas tube roll pin requires a number 2 or 5/64 inch roll pin punch and a number 2 or 3.5 millimeter roll pin holder. The sight taper pins use a 3/32 taper starter punch for installation or removal. Brownell sells this specific punch, and trust me, this is definitely one that you'll need. For the sling swivel, you'll need a staking punch and a flat punch to peen over the rivet that holds the sling swivel in place. And to make working on the front sight block easier, you may want to consider the Brownells front sight block in a 4-ounce ball peen hammer. The front sight bench block provides an easy method for securing your front sight gas block. For the upper receiver, you'll work with 1 pin size for the A1 sight and 2 pin sizes for the A2. The A1 sight uses a number 1 or 16th inch roll pin punch and holder for the windage drum roll pin. The A2 uses the number 1 and the number 3 or 3/32 roll pin punches and holders for the windage drum and elevation housing pin respectively. The rear sight elevation spring tool is also necessary for installing the A2 sight. The forward assist requires a number 3 roll pin punch and holder to install the retaining pin. And if you're going to fully assemble the forward assist, you'll also need a number 1 roll pin holder and punch. For the lower receiver, you'll need a number 3 roll pin punch and holder for bolt catch and trigger guard roll pins. If for some reason you need to disassemble the trigger guard plunger, it requires a number 1 roll pin holder and punch. To assemble the trigger, you'll need a 151,000 diameter punch for your trigger and hammer pins. This punch will work for all trigger and hammer pin sizes. To install the pistol grip, you'll need a long flathead screwdriver with a shaft about 4 inches long and a 7/16 inch wide radius cut head. This will prevent you from stripping the head of the screw. The screwdriver can also be used for the buttstock screws. Our larger MagnaTip flathead bits with our standard MagnaTip handle works great for this. Other tools that you should have are a good bench vise, some pads for your vise jaws, a torque wrench capable of torquing from 30 to 150 foot-pounds, an inch-pound torque wrench, a set of needle-nose pliers, a nylon brass hammer, a sight adjustment tool for your type of sights, some small containers to organize parts, a field headspace gauge for your caliber, an AR-15 magazine, dummy cartridges for your caliber, a 3/32 starting punch, an ejector removal tool, and a bench mat to keep from scratching your rifle and the small parts from rolling around. Other tools that you'd like to have include a handguard removal tool if you're installing or removing a standard handguard set, a strap wrench if you're installing a free-float handguard, a gas tube alignment pin, a breaker bar for extra leverage, a set of snap ring pliers, a pivot pin detent installation tool, a set of English and metric hex wrenches, and a set of torque bits. For extensive work on your AR-15 rifle, you may want to consider either our field maintenance packs or our armor kits.